Today we're going to have a look at the steps and settings I used to achieve the results from my recent Gyroflow handheld A-B comparison video for REDCODE RAW footage. There's a few important things to note before we dig into the settings though. One, this will only work natively with current model RED cameras, which are the Komodo series and the V-Raptor series, as they feature gyroscopic metadata capture in camera. Two, the recording must be REDCODE RAW, as the gyro metadata is not written to ProRes recordings. And three, the Gyroflow plugin is currently only available for DaVinci Resolve as well as Final Cut Pro, but a version for Premiere and After Effects is planned for future release. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is open the standalone version of Gyroflow and load our R3D file by clicking on the Open File button in the upper left panel. As we have a look at the playthrough of the unstabilized footage, it's worth mentioning that all of the settings I'll be suggesting here were all arrived upon by changing each setting individually and comparing the results. It's also highly recommended that you create a custom lens profile for your lens and focal length, as it's really not difficult to do and you only need to ever do it once. I'll be following this video up with another Gyroflow video that will be dedicated to creating lens profiles, so stay tuned for that. Now that we've seen what our unstabilized footage looks like, it's time to load our lens profile. As you can see, I've already created one for the lens and focal length I shot this scene with. I then activate the low-pass filter checkbox. Next, I move the playhead to an area of the footage where all of the axis lines are close to being converged, and then right-click and select Estimate Gyro Bias. Once complete, change the integration method to complementary. Now we head over to the upper right panel and open up the advanced options underneath the synchronization section. First, make sure that the processing resolution is set to 4K, and then select the first OpenCV optical flow method. Change the pose method to the 8-point option, and once again turn on the low pass filter checkbox. Set the smoothness slider to 1 second for the initial synchronization. And then turn on the lock horizon checkbox and adjust the roll angle correction to best level your scene. Now it's time to click on the auto sync button at the top of the panel. Once the synchronization completes, we can go down and toggle the stabilization overview on so we can get an idea of how Gyroflow is manipulating the original footage to work within a stabilized frame. If I'm happy overall with the stabilization results I'm seeing, I'm then going to change my synchronization settings for final output. I'll change the optical flow method to AKs. But be warned, this significantly slows down the synchronization, and I'm also going to turn on the detected features and optical flow points so that we can see all of the synchronization points before we export the final. I do find the AK's optical flow method to be the most accurate stabilization, but if you're in a time crunch, I'd recommend probably skipping it, as it does take quite a long time. As I prepare for final export, I'm just going to adjust my stabilization smoothness down to a half a second, as for this scene, that's going to give me the best balance between smoothness and focal length. Lastly, I'm just going to review the stabilization on the footage one last time to make sure that I'm more or less happy with everything before I export the final project. Okay, now that we're ready to export the project file, we're just going to click on the down arrow beside the export button and select Export Project File, including Processed Gyro Data. You can verify that this is done correctly by opening the file folder with the original footage in it, and you should now see a .gyroflow project file. Okay, now it's time to head over to DaVinci, so we're just going to import our original REDCODE RAW clip and drop it into the timeline. I recommend that you have all of your caching options turned on so that you can review any changes in real time once it's cached. And you can do that by heading up to the top, clicking on the playback menu item, switching your render cache to user and your Fusion memory cache turned on, and then right clicking on your clip and checking render cache for color output and render cache Fusion output. Make sure they're both turned on. Next, we switch over to the Fusion tab, and clicking on Media 1, you're just going to hit Shift and Spacebar, type in Gyro, and add the Gyroflow tool, and then simply go up and load for current file. That will load your Gyroflow project file. I'd already created a quick grade for this scene, so I'm just applying it over in the Color tab. Next, we're just going to head back to the edit page just to trim the clip up a little bit. It's always going to be a little less stable at the beginning, so I'm just going to trim the beginning until I find the point where I'd actually like the video to begin. Okay, once we've got it all trimmed up, we're just going to move the playhead back to the beginning and allow DaVinci to cache the clip, both from the color page and the fusion page. So this will take a few minutes, and I'm just going to time ramp through it so that we don't have to wait. Okay, now that our clip is fully cached, we can go ahead and preview it. And there is our freshly stabilized Gyroflow footage from our REDCODE RAW original. So that's it for this one. Do me a favor, if you found this video helpful or insightful in any way, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button, like the video. It's really going to help me with creating more content moving forward. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.